fighting out of the red corner. He wears it with blue and red shorts. He weighed in at around 142.8 pounds. He is undefeated in his campaign as a professional with a record of 8 victories. No defeats. He has 1 draw and 3 wins coming by way of knockout. From Brooklyn, New York, ladies and gentlemen, Mikkel Lespierre.
We're checking in here backstage. The man in front of the cam needs no kind of introduction. It's Slick Mick, Mikkel Lespierre. We're now on the other side of another knockout out there, Mick. Let's go ahead and first and foremost walk the people through the fight a little bit and just talk about how comfortable you felt out there tonight.
First, I just want to thank God for this victory and for just giving me the strength to put on a good show to the best of my ability, 110%. And you know, like I said before, we train hard. You know, we work extremely hard in the gym. I knew this guy, Larry Venuts. I mean, even though he lost his last six or seven. I still wasn't taking any credit away from him because he's been in there with like top prospects. So I went in there to just you know, see what I had in front of me. Like I said, I saw tape on him before, but we don't really go by tape until we get in the ring. You know, because what he did probably 2 years ago is probably totally, he could be in a totally different mindset coming into this fight. He might see me as a stepping stone. If he knocked me off, he back in the mix. So, you know, we took the fight very seriously. I saw what he gave me in the first round, which was really nothing. I controlled the tempo. He couldn't punch. It was like he really didn't want to be in there. So I said, you know what? If he doesn't, then I'll take my time and do what's necessary to get the stoppage. And that's what we did. We got him on in the third round.
Absolutely. And the first knockdown, Mick, came in the second round. And you stayed true to your cause, were patient, didn't jump in anything to get yourself exposed to something unnecessary. Went ahead and finished off the job in the third. But, you know, talk about the patience a little bit, what you saw, how you knew you had him on the edge there. And, you know, pulled him along a little bit to finish him off in the third.
Well, like I said before, I'm a patient fighter. You know, I take my time in there. Sometimes I could probably wait a little too long, but it's all in for me to get my rhythm and to make the necessary adjustments that's needed for me to get it back on track. With him, I just stayed calm. You know, I saw everything that he was throwing. He wasn't landing much. He wasn't throwing much. So I said, you know what? Let me just apply the pressure and just finish the job. You know, and I just opened up and look for the openings. Look for, you know, create the combinations that, you know, did what was necessary for him to take the first knockdown. And then at the third round, I just kept at it, stayed composed, kept him with the straight, short, stiff shots. Went to the body a little bit, went to the head, took a knee, then went right back to the body again. And then that was it.
No doubt. And now, a win is always the most important thing, but, you know, a stoppage has always got to be special, you know. How good do you feel, you know, just to get that stoppage victory again? The W is the only thing that matters, but, you know, to throw another knockout up on your record.
It feels good, man, because I haven't been fighting easy fights. You know, I've fought two tough, since the beginning of this year, I fought all four tough fights. This one being not a tough fight, you know, a fight catered to me, you know, and I did what I had to do. But the fights prior to this, you know, I wasn't walkovers. Those guys were experienced guys, 18 and better fights. I'm still in my single digits, you know. I just became 9-0, you know. So it's like it's a test for me every time, you know. So I love the challenge. The challenge is only going to build me as a fighter, mentally and physically. And that's what we're here to do. You know, we here to stay. We're not here to. This ain't a facade. Like I do what's necessary in order to win. Whether it's a tough earned home victory or whether it's an easy fought victory or whether it's a well earned stoppage, you know. So that's what we do.
Absolutely. And now a couple of things, Mick, with tonight. Obviously, you've been busy this year, so that's kept you, you know, you always stayed in the gym. But now you've been actually able to stay in fight fitness in terms of, you know, the that draw of a fight day is something different from any other day. So you've been getting a lot of fights this year, stay busy. And the second thing is you really kind of figured out some things with your weight as well, to the point where you look very comfortable in there. Just talk about your comfort level in there, how all that's kind of contributed.
Last fight, I think I dropped the weight a little too fast, so I was a little lethargic, you know, I was a little fatigued early on after like the third round, but I felt I dropped the weight perfectly this time. I made weight before the weigh-in, the day before the weigh-in, comfortably, you know. I wasn't losing 6 or 7, 8 pounds to make the weight. I wasn't starving myself to make the weight. I ate comfortably, I ate good, you know, so I was able to do that this time and rehydrate properly, you know, and that showed definitely in the fight today. I felt good, I felt strong, and that's what I meant.
Absolutely great performance out there, Mick. Well-deserved stoppage and victory, but to finish this off, any closing words you have out there for the people?
I just want to say, you know, thank you to everybody that supported me, Team Slick Mick. You know, we here, like I said, we here to stay. I just want you guys to continue to support me. You know, I work hard, I train hard, you know, just to put on a good show for you guys. And, you know, just to do bigger and better things in the near future.
Absolutely. All right, Mick. On to the next. Keep doing what you're doing.
Ladies and gentlemen, referee David Fields calls a halt to this contest. The official time of the stoppage, 1 minute and 13 seconds of round number 3. The winner by TKO, he's still undefeated, from Brooklyn, New York, Mikkel Lespierre.